Good afternoon, Mrs. Jones. I'm so happy to meet with you. We've come from Six Mile Way North because we're looking for some property. My husband has given me permission to start a millinery shop and a dressmaking shop. I brought Sadie with me today. Hopefully she can give some of the wares to the milliner. My sons, they're grown. They're getting ready to leave home because of the Santa Fe Trail that's been going right past our property all these years. They now have the gold fever. They're going to come and get on a wagon train, hopefully, to find more gold. However, they're going to have to stop at the slave auction this weekend and get more chattel because they're being some of our hardest workers. We need to replace them. Now, Sadie here has become very adept at dressmaking with me, and she's hoping to set up a shop with me. Now, if they come up here and they get their wagons geared out and go, we might even be able to start a school then for some of the children that are actually coming from Santa Fe. There were so many on the trails that came. The poor little things, their legs were just worn to nothing. Nothing like being on our hemp farm, which, as you well know, is quite huge now. We were so lucky to grow because we came with several people with us from Kentucky. Actually, we have Sadie's parents and her cousins that came with us, and so we have approximately 60 members of that chattel family. We're so happy that you would entertain giving us an opportunity to start a dress shop, and my husband has allowed me to save my egg money so that I have the money to pay you. Are there any questions about going there? I don't know, Sadie, how do you feel about this? Of course, you're excited to be with us in town today. There was a long journey. She got to see so many things she'd never seen before, especially coming past the big river, the big Missouri River, and waiting for the ferry to bring us across. It was a little bit challenging. It got a little rough. We've had a lot of rain recently, and that's why the farm is just growing. And my sons, they've grown so much. I've got the 16-year-old Joshua and the 18-year-old Jonathan. And then my poor 12-year-old got to stay on the farm with my husband. He's actually looking at more land to build more of a rope barn. He wants to add another mile to our already 2-mile rope barn so that we can get more money for us to start my business here. The school, I hope, will be able to start also here on the square. I understand there's only one schoolhouse now in Independence. And in 1849, everything is just growing and being hugely important to everybody that's coming from all outside our country. Coming into town, we're very concerned. Sadie was concerned that she didn't have any traveling papers, but being with me, she's perfectly within the rights of the Code Noir here in Missouri, which we templated after Louisiana so that we could keep our slave families together and keep our businesses going. Now, being a mulatto, when she has 3 white grandparents and 1 African grandparent, that's very important to know, because if she were traveling by herself, she would need those papers. But she stays with me, and that way you don't get lost within the crowds coming here into Independence. If that were to happen, the patrollers would come at least once a week and find these persons. And they were allowed to give them in the public square at least 10 stripes, depending if they had to put up much of a struggle to get them, to keep them in line so that we can set an example for those who might have a little wanderlust or laying aside, as it were, for a few hours in the woods away from people. As we are traveling and going about the city, she will stay close to me, will you not, Sadie? Yes, of course. We won't let the wanderlust get away with you. And so it's as with the law, we are allowed to perhaps I could contract you out if you could do well with the milliner in the square, and we'll put up a contract so that you could work with her, perhaps, if you take a liking to living in town. It seems there are a lot of bright, happy things going. But I need Sadie with me, and that's why I'm grateful to have her whole family that we brought into Missouri when we took up farming. Mrs. Jones, it has been a delight chatting with you about a potential shop on the square. I do have an appointment with a Mrs. Martin up on the square as well to look at another property. I do appreciate your time, and I thank you very kindly. Sadie?